There is a massive solid-state battery update. A Chinese company has massive breakthrough friends. A new material that a Chinese university developed from the University of Science and Technology of China shows much promise in helping solid-state battery technology for electric vehicles to become commercially viable sooner than before. Here's what we know so far. Welcome back, dear friends. This is Armin Haryan from TorqueNews.com. If you are here first time, please take a moment, subscribe to our channel, join our community, and ring the bell so you don't miss my next coverage. And please give us thumbs up and share it in social media. We would greatly appreciate it. So when we think of the future of battery technology, solid state seems like a pipe dream, even with Toyota making as much headway with their promise on solid state batteries. Nothing is on the market right now that uses the famed kind of quote unquote savior of electric vehicle technology as a battery. One of the ongoing problems with solid state battery is the cost of production coupled with the longevity. Even with breakthroughs from Samsung that utilize a special lining to increase battery life, we still do not see this battery technology being used. But after recent news from a university in China, that's the University of Science and Technology in China, all that could change and faster than we think. So what is this breakthrough with solid-state electric vehicle battery? New material was developed called lithium zirconium chloride. The benefits of this material are cost, performance, and stability. All of the significant issues with solid-state come from these three factors. The batteries have gone through several types of experimentation, according to the university, including materials, electrolytes, and cathodes. The most significant hurdle is a cost of production. Friends, currently, solid state battery production costs 23.05 meters per square. Again, remember this, $23.05 per meter square. And with this new material, that cost per square meter would be lower to $1.38 per meter square. This is revolutionary from bringing this technology to the market, bringing from $23 to $1. Other notable mentions, zirconium is one of the materials used in this new solid state battery. The material is found in abundance, which helps with cost effective production and scalability. If everything goes the way we see in this news release, that means China will be way ahead with solid-state battery production, maybe ahead than Toyota, but I have big news coming from elsewhere too. So we not see battery technology in full swing right now. I believe these massive breakthroughs will allow us to get there faster in terms of solid-state battery technology. More people are seeing the help that solid-state will provide in the transition to an electric vehicle dominant future, says Peter Nelson of Torque News, Toyota, and Hybrid Vehicle Reporting Team. Costs are always a concern and longevity, but if this university in China says they have solved the problem, we need to put it to the test and see what happens after this and when it comes, because it's going to be commercially viable. I would love to see solid state batteries for electric cars be available for new cars and older hybrids that need new batteries. This would help offset the carbon footprint we currently make with lithium ion and other lithium type productions that use cobalt. In the meantime, there is also another big news about solid state batteries coming from the United States. Volkswagen-backed QuantumScape is testing a 10-layer solid-state battery cell. QuantumScape, an electric vehicle battery company that went public last fall, said Tuesday it has advanced to testing 10-layer cells, a sign it's on track in efforts to develop a commercially viable solid-state battery. QuantumScape, which counts Volkswagen as its biggest shareholder, is among a group of companies developing solid-state batteries, which could dramatically speed up electric vehicle adoption by providing a safer, cheaper alternative to current lithium-ion batteries. It has benefited from booming investor interest in electric cars and the technology needed to make and improve them. Friends, While the technology has cleared some technical hurdles, QuantumScape still has a long way to go to demonstrate it can manufacture its new battery at scale. Looks like the Chinese university's findings will bring it closer to make them commercially viable, and QuantumScape is getting closer too. So QuantumScape said in February it had produced 4-layer cells, a crucial step in taking the technology to the real world. Now QuantumScape is talking about 10-layer cell. Now, I don't understand much about these things, but the announcement on Tuesday marks another step forward in the process, though QuantumScape said it would disclose more testing data later this year. So we're going to wait and see so we can have more information and explain you better. Here's a quote I want to present you. While we need to produce and test many more such cells to collect data and statistics to their performance and reliability, this is an extremely important result, the company said in a letter to shareholders. In the steps toward commercialization of electric vehicle solid-state batteries, QuantumScape will also have to show testing on larger battery formats, which is closer to what automakers use for massive assembly of vehicles. But now QuantumScape has gone from 4-layer cell to 10-layer cell, and that breakthrough from China. Shares of QuantumScape company were little change in extended trading after the announcement. They have been pummeled this year, plunging 75% through Tuesday, as short sellers targeted the company. The stock is now worth a sixth of its December peak of $132.73. Like I said earlier, I'm not in stock market. This is just for your information, friends. In March, QuantumScape raised about $463 million, less than initially sought, to fund expansion of a pilot battery production line in California and a separate line it's building with Volkswagen as part of a 50-50 joint venture. The latter is supposed to start producing cells as soon as 2024. Solid-state batteries keep on attracting tremendous attention and investment with the maturing technologies and closeness to mass production. Even with the influence of this current virus, the potential market size is of solid-state batteries is expected to grow to over $8 billion by 2031, according to ID Tech's report. So since their commercialization in 1991, lithium-ion batteries have received worldwide success. However, this cannot hide their intrinsic limitations in terms of safety, performance, and form factor. This is why solid-state batteries now replace organic liquid electrolytes with solid-state counterparts, enabling safer, long-lasting batteries. In addition, solid-state electrolytes can be compatible with high-voltage cathode materials and high-capacity lithium metal anodes. So, looks like very interesting news coming, breakthroughs coming. We're getting closer to solid-state battery commercialization. The Chinese company has about 23 times lower the price, and the QuantumScape is making bigger battery cells. Let's see where we get in the next 1 or 2 years with solid-state battery news for electric vehicle friends. This is Armin Haryan from TorqueNews.com. Please subscribe to our channel for daily electric vehicle news. Let me know what you think about solid-state batteries. Maybe you know more information. Send me some tips. I would greatly appreciate. I'll look forward to hearing your comments, and I'll see you soon in our next report. Give us thumbs up, please, if you found this report informative, and share in social media. You will help to speed up the electric vehicle transition by providing more information to people. God bless you, everyone. Peace be with all of you, and I'll see you soon in our next report.